Good morning, fellow option traders. This is Jeff, and welcome to the Daily Scan for Thursday, March 27th, 2014. All right, yesterday's news, no surprises, kind of mixed. Some up, some down. I don't know how to interpret what happened with the petroleum status report, except to say that there was some words about refineries not producing so much gasoline, which of course is keeping the price up. Thanks a lot, guys. I really appreciate that. For today, we have GDP and jobless claims, our typical, well, jobless claims every week, and GDP, I think, is this is probably a monthly report, I'm guessing. Pending home sales at 10 a.m., and that's about it. Let's jump over and take a look at what's going on across the big ponds. Asia is mixed, and Europe is, well, it was red across the board when I looked at it about a half hour ago. But it looks like as though some indexes are recovering. So you can see here that it was pretty low. Same thing here. Yeah, they all kind of look the same. And they're shooting up right now. So that's interesting. And then on the news front, nothing real exciting. This might be interesting. Home equity lines and then this bubble thing. So, yeah, you might want to read up on that possibly. But again, we trade what we see. All right, I wanted to let you know that today I should be able to get to the results for the CSSV2 trades up to and including this week. Been getting some questions on that, and I have been negligent. I know the account's doing good because I'm, you know, I do them all in this account, and In the 85 account, I guess you could call it, and a 34 account, I've been trying to stick to mostly calendars just to keep things separated from a performance perspective. And I am in the process now of collecting that data since February. Okay, now looking at what's going on over here, it looks like as though we're going to open up slightly. Not real happy about what's happening with gold here below 1300, and oil is right at 100 effectively. And then for Chevron, they got the okay to do a shallow water well or shallow water, some sort of well over Myanmar. So they had a little bit of a pop on that stock. So I'm not sure exactly what I'm going to do about this calendar. Since it's a put calendar and I'm looking for a move to the downside, let's go and take a look at the A-plus list here. And we'll look at Chevron right off the bat here. Pop up the chart. So I have this April-May calendar. I have some time for it to mature, but it's not looking real good. And I may decide to get out before I lose too much money. So we're about 50% loss right now, approximately. I may want to get out of that. I'll take a look at that today. All right, and you may notice here I'm getting this. I don't know. I sent an email to him. So what the heck does this mean? I have to subscribe for this? Or is this something new that I'm going to have to pay for? I don't know if this is a new bug that was introduced overnight. I have no idea. Somebody did something there that's causing me not to be able to get implied volatility and then IV percentile. So I'm not exactly sure what's going on there. So we'll wait to see what I hear back from them. And we can jump right over to the A-plus list, and as usual, we'll look at any open positions that we may have. So here we are with Apple, had a couple of nice days, and now it looks like we might be pulling back. I'm not sure. I'm taking this off of here because I don't know which the heck direction this thing is going to be going now. Looks like as though it may be in a new uptrend. I'm not sure. So we will just wait on that one. Amazon, nothing current. Amazon is not looking real good here, so we are waiting for it to come up here and give us an entry. Could do a calendar. I'm just not sure exactly where the heck this thing is going to end up. Let's do a regression channel from this high here. Well, if it keeps up with that, I think we might need to go over a slightly longer period of time. So how about from this high to now? Okay, so that, I don't know, it seems to be, I don't think that's going to work out very well. I don't think that that's the thing that we want to be looking for. So, I'm going to take this out of here. And now I just don't really know exactly what to do about this. So we have a low here and a low here, and now we're hitting it again. I don't know. We might end up bouncing off of that, which would be good because then it would come up here and give us an entry. And then a continuation down. Look what happened after hours yesterday. Then it came right back down again. That is pretty interesting. Okay. Boeing. We're looking at, this would be, it would have been like a 20 delta. And would be okay. It would be working out all right. I should lock this. I don't know what it was yesterday, but I think it was in a little bit better than $33, though. Looks like as though it probably was maybe 2 cents more, maybe. Looking at theta, not sure. I don't remember exactly what it was. But anyway, that was the thought at that time, was this particular trade. And it would be working out okay right now. Is there a CSSV2 in the future? No. We did not get a setup here. Even though we have a hook, we didn't get a setup. We need to get below this 30, preferably below the 20. Before we get our nice little green line here. Didn't get it. BIDU. Okay, we're waiting for it to come up here and give us an entry. It's taking its ever-loving time. It's a pretty powerful move down. There's not even an entry for a... This looks a lot like Amazon. I'm going to take a look at these today and see what I can, what kind of trade we can come up for these two. We'll see what happens. Look at this morning. Wow. That's, Baidu's in trouble. How can we take advantage of that? If I could do a naked call. But that just ties up way too much capital, even if you can do it. Could just buy some puts. I mean, this is a big move. This is a nice day trade here. I mean, buy a put when it opens. I mean, you don't know which way it's going to go, but buy a put when it opens. Keep a close eye on it. Have a target. Get out when you made your profit. That works. And here we are coming up here with, we're going to retest this low back here. And we're actually going to be, looks like we might open at it here. Gap down. Wow. Okay, we'll be thinking about that one. Celgene. Celgene, we still are heading down here. We're coming up here for a nice setup. Maybe we might get another nice move in our stochastic here for today. If we get a little bit of positive action here, maybe a slightly green candle, that would be good. That would be very good. I need to recover some from some of my losses on Celgene for this year. So we're waiting for that one to mature a little bit. Okay, Chipotle, we came down here now. We have a setup again. I think they were in there yesterday too, weren't they? No, Google was in yesterday. So let me make a note of that. All right. Costco. Never got up here high enough for us to get in. That's a shame. We have a note on them anywhere along here? No, nothing. So this would be a pretty good entry here for a 20 delta. Because we did have a pullback here and it looks like as though it's going to continue. So if we were to look for a 20 delta, I think that expiration this week might be asking for a lot. But we'll see here. Do we have a 20? We have a 35 and a 12. So that's not good enough. We may have to go out into next week. Let me knock this down here. I got way too many. 20 delta. Here's a 26 at 114. 114 is here. I might have to go out a little bit further in order to get a cushion that I'm comfortable with. And here we're at $5 spreads, but here's one at 27, which is 115. That has possibilities. We'll see what kind of premium we're getting. 59 cents. That's not too bad. And there goes the furnace. So if we go here, we want this April expiration. Here's our probability. We have a 75% approximate probability of this expiring successfully, profitably. And we're looking at $441 in risk for $59 in credit. I just don't like doing those. But if you want to, a lot of people do these kinds of trades. If you want to, that would be the way that I used to do them. And I was successful, but man, it was hard. It was very stressful. I just feel that this CSSV2 is less stressful because you're putting less at risk. You're, when you have a risk reward of 1-to-1, 50-50 chance, I guess you might say, with momentum on your side, I feel a lot better about that. And, you know, you might even do that now. I mean, you don't have to follow my rules when you make a trade. I don't have to follow my rules either, and I don't all the time. Now, LinkedIn is a good example when we get to that. But it's a good idea to at least follow most of them. So I did make a note on Costco that it might just go in there and do a 50-50. And it would be for tomorrow expiration if I was to do that. And 112.49, so we do one at 112. That's 52 cents, 48 cents risk. I mean, you know, take the chance. Take the chance. That's what I say. If you don't trade, you're not going to make any money. Of course, you're not going to lose any money either, but you have to, the numbers work against you if you're overly picky. So generally, as a rule, you know, you got to have the the volume in there. All right, so let's move over to, I'm going to lock this. Let's move over to CVX. CVX had a nice day yesterday with a big gap up. I'm going to have to figure out if I want to get out of this calendar or not, because right now we are at a 130 loss. Yeah, about 50% like I mentioned before. So I am going to consider exiting that today. I just threw DIA into my list today. I haven't traded it in a long, long time. So we're going to take a look at that just to look at the chart, which generally, as a rule, follows the Dow Jones Industrials 30 very picky stocks. It's not a good index in my mind just because it only has 30. But it's the most popular one and it's the most quoted one. So we're going to take a look at it every day, and where it's looking kind of flat here. So no trades in my mind on that one. Igor. Okay, we had a failure down here. So this is no longer valid. We need to, I guess we can delete all drawings. We need to wait for this to come back again. Come down here and give us an entrance. FedEx. FedEx is coming down. I'm still thinking about what I wanted to do about that. I'm very glad I did not do this 130. I would be kicking myself if I would have done that. So I'm still, it's still on my list to at least check out and figure out what I might be able to do on it. Gold, there's my covered call, and gold is not looking real good, and overnight, it's not looking real good. Google. Had a violation here, so this is no longer valid. I'll delete everything in case there's something else in there that I don't see. Same thing here. Ladies and gentlemen, we looks like we are going to get a change in the trend on Google, if you can believe that. And it looks like it's going to, well, maybe not. Last trade was here, but still going to gap down probably at the open. So want to buy a put? There's something funny going on with all the NASDAQ leaders. IWM, wow. It's moving so fast, the regression channel can't even keep up with it. Wow, that's a fast mover. Actually, I probably need to move this. It did move. Okay, we are to there. We're on this candle. That's good. So this is just saying that it's the probability of it ending up in this range by this date. So we have IWM as another one, which is, maybe this is a sign, which is the Russell 2000 small caps. Small caps generally lead. So it looks like we might have another pullback like we have here. So we might jump on, violate rules like crazy and jump on these things and do our CSS V2s. Totally against the rules, but just that there's so much momentum here. This is a lot. And maybe we can ride this. We'll see what happens. LinkedIn, still in it. Here we have, should have exited yesterday. We have two greens. Did not. I was watching it off and on, and I decided just to hang on. Made about 30 bucks on it yesterday. Nothing new showing up for an entry. And here we have MasterCard also taking a digger, but not the kind of digger that I'm feeling real confident in, because this is kind of a new downtrend here. So we're going to wait. Or I'm going to wait. You can wait too if you want. Triple M. It's definitely not going. This is a 20 delta trade. You know, you could say anything that's above this 135 mark, because it just is not going to get above it. It just refuses to. We have a print here at 134, but I don't think it's going to get above 135. Just doesn't. There's quite some resistance around there. So that might be a good one if you want to do like a 136 or something like that. Bear call, that could be a good one. Netflix. Oh, Netflix, yes, yes. Where is our... Okay, we need to move this over to here so that we include the data for yesterday. And we're still, looks like as though it's going to be taking a ride down. So that could be another one. These all would be like overnight CESSV2 trades. Could make a lot of money. I'm going to add that to the list too. Although, momentum-wise, it doesn't look as juicy as the other ones. We'll have to think about that. Priceline. Priceline has been really heading south. This is just a line. Let's activate the drawing, bring it down here to include this day. And now we have a new direction here. So this Priceline is also another one. We could make some really good jingwa on this overnight. Momentum, screaming to the downside. Not screaming quite as loudly as some of the other ones, but let's take a look at the spiders. And let's make sure that we're including, yeah, I wish it would automatically follow it, or it'd be a moving 15 or 14. 15 would probably be good. All right, what are we seeing here? We are seeing a definite, we don't have a trend reversal yet, but we are seeing a little bit of momentum to the downside, not quite as heavy as the Russell. Tesla. All right, we had a failure, and this alert is no longer valid. We'll just get rid of that, and we will get rid of delete all drawings on Tesla. And here we have, you know, another one. It's been having some definite negative momentum for quite a while. We're killing the rules because I think we're in a new market here. At least, especially for the NASDAQ and the Russell. And last but not least is Visa. And we need to have this include this candle. And it's moving much faster than the regression line is. We could change this to a channel. Let's delete it. And we'll go back 5, 10, 15 approximately here. 5, 10, 15. Yeah, from here. Include this day, and that's where we're headed. And we got some momentum piling onto the negative side, and the stochastic is about to tank at zero. It can't go any further than zero. It's currently at 8.7. No, actually, it's at zero. It is at zero. I was looking at the purple one, which is the moving average. So it is at zero. So Visa could be another one we could add to our list. And I will. Wow, we got a lot of CSS V2 trades that we want to catch this falling knife, I guess you might say. Anyway, let's see how it turns out today. Okay, so that's it for Thursday. Thank you very much for watching. Have a great day and happy trading.